This is Travis Zimmerman of Speak My Word Ministries, the Daily Pulse. Today, the episode concerns then as now, free will causes a lot of issues. And I say that because of this. You know, God gives us choices. And even the original couple, Adam and Eve, were given choices in the Garden of Eden. And I want to go to that. I went back in January, I looked at my notes, and I referenced this scripture back in January. I think it was January. And I want to reference it now on a different angle. And God gave the first couple, as it were, choices, a choice. And it's this. It's Genesis chapter 2, verse 15 to 17, known to many of you here. And it's a humbling and sobering passage. Genesis chapter 2, verses 15 to 17. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work and take care of it. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You are free to eat from any tree in the garden, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. For when you eat of it, you will surely die." Wow. Genesis chapter 2, verses 15 to 17. You're not free. You're not allowed to eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Adam and Eve had one choice to make, and one bad choice they could make. And as we know, and it's painful, whether it had been Adam and Eve or Travis and Suzanne, any one of us would have busted that commandment. So it's not a pointed condemnation against Adam and Eve. It's against us, our sinful nature. God gave us choices, and that choice back then resulted in a lot of difficulties. They got cast out of the garden, and he said to the man, "You're going to have to scratch a living out of the soil, and the woman is going to have pain in childbirth, and it's going to be a remembrance of that original sin." And we're born with the seminal sin, as it were. We're born with sin. That was then. Now is we have all kinds of choices. Choices not just of a tree to eat, but then again, even though we have all kinds of choices, it still comes down to the same thing God was talking to Adam and Eve about. It was, will you choose to obey me? Will you go my way, in other words, God's way? Or will you go your own way, which leads to death? And God gives us that free will. He allows us to choose. We can choose to wear red shoes or green shoes, or we can choose to sleep in or get up early, or what job we do in many cases, or how many kids we want to have, or what kind of car we drive. Yeah, we have all kinds of choices. And that free will God gives us is actually a gift, because he allows us to choose these things, but ultimately he allows us to choose him or to reject him. And make no mistake, God already knows what choices we're going to make. God knows everything. There's nothing outside of his purview. As is often said, something you never heard God say, "Wow, I didn't see that coming." You know, God sees everything. But he gave us that free will, and that same free will that Adam and Eve struggled with, we struggle with. And that's why he gave us the Holy Spirit, to help us make those good decisions, to bring glory and honor to him with the choices that we make. In Jesus' name, amen.